My name's Zach Parker, owner of Scott's Barbecue, Pitmaster. I'm 25 years old. We're in Lexington, Tennessee. It's between Memphis and Nashville. We cook whole hog barbecue here. We start at 7 in the morning, we get them on, and we don't take them off till 7 the next morning, so it's a 24-hour process.
My name's Zach Parker. I'm 14. I was born in May 20th, 1991. My dad's the owner of Scott's Barbecue. His name's Ricky Parker. I love pulling it up and getting it, putting it in the pound trays for people when they want it. I love making their sandwiches and everything else. Our barbecue, when you put it in your mouth, it's just, it's easy to eat, tender. It tastes better than pizza and Taco Bell, I'll tell you that.
Dad worked here since the early 80s. He bought it in 89. He had my brother in 89, he had me in 91, and we've been hustling ever since. It was always a goal of mine to help my dad, and I wanted to learn his trade, and I wanted to keep the tradition alive, but it was also about making him proud. Him and Mom got divorced as I was young, so once they got divorced, I was here 24/7. If he was here, I was here. I literally started from the bottom doing the dirty work from cleaning, shoveling pits out, and then when I finally got tall enough and old enough to understand the process of serving the barbecue, that was my final stage along with learning how to cook them. And it's a hard deal to explain because it's not like a manual comes with cooking a whole hog. Because if anybody could ever come up with that and it be spot on every time, everybody would be doing it. And it took me a few years to learn how to cook just like Dad did, but once he showed me, it stuck with me forever.
It's fun to me what some people call work, but it's not really work. I think it's fun. I learned it by my dad. He showed me most of it. And pretty much barbecuing is simple now. He's got a couple more things he needs to show me, like what to do in between firings and how to fire the pigs. But he usually takes care of all that.
Zach has picked up on a lot of everything that's going on. At any given time, I can ask him, Zach, you want to take care of the front or you want to go back there and fire the meat? But now, whether he wants to tolerate what I do is a different story.
I was going to school, but that sort of fell through. Dad passed away, and I was almost through with EMT school, and I sort of knew that I had things to do, and I had to make sure his legacy lived on. That meant enough to me to drop out of school and take over the business and make sure it was right and done the exact same way. Dad was he was old-timey. He was a guy that if you didn't do it his way, he'd let you know it. And that was a good thing because now I have all that stored in the back of my head and I'm able to say, all right, what would Dad do? And it may be the longest drawn out process, but now that he's passed away and I have to repeat the process every day, I understand why he would do it that way. Because, I mean, there's just no change in barbecue. If you want it to be right and you want it to be like it used to be, you have to keep doing it the hard way. If you don't do it the hard way, it just don't work out. I mean, if you take the work out of it, is it really worth it? Is it worth doing if you take the work out of it? Not to me, it's not.
Nothing easy about it, but I like to do it. But I mean, if you don't do something just right, the whole thing's messed up. I wouldn't trust it just anybody to know how to do it, because it's hard work.
It's a part of me, which I know when you give your vows when you get married, I know it says death to us part. And see, and you and your wife supposed to be as one. Well, now, this and me is as one. Without me, there ain't no barbecue place. Not Scott's, anyway.
If I could have one conversation with Dad, I would first off tell him he was a hell of a man for doing everything that he'd done, from raising two boys to running a business that he had to put his whole life into, really. I mean, you know, he never had time for anything. He didn't have, we went fishing on Sundays, but that was it. And that was because the day we was closed, you know. But if I sat down and talked to him, I'd definitely tell him how hard I know it is now that I didn't realize then, because he took all the stress part of it out of it for me, and I never realized how much of it come along with a business. You have to fully understand how much sacrifice there is, because that's something I didn't fully understand until Dad passed away. I used to sit back and think, you know, my friends, you know, they'd ask me when I was in high school to go to ball games. They'd want me to go do things with them, and my dad would make me work. Well, that's the time we'd bump heads then, because I'd be like, dang, you know, I'm in high school. Hey, let me go to this game or something. But now I appreciate every bit of that, because it made me the person I am today. I'm 110% glad that I followed in his footsteps. Since he's passed away, I've probably visited his grave 6 or 8 times. But when I go to the graveyard, it's like I don't feel him there. When I have issues, I want to be at this place right here, because this is where we had most of our memories. And I feel like when I'm here, I make the right decisions, because a lot of times when he first passed away, I was bad about what would Dad do in this situation. It wouldn't be what Zach wanted to do. And it's hard, because a lot of people expect you to be just like him. My thing is, let me do what he was doing, but let me make my own path as well. I mean, I've been walking in these doors here at Scott's Barbecue my whole life. It's all I've ever known, you know. I'm old school. I want to keep doing it the way he was doing it, and I want to make sure that legacy lives on. You know, I'm big on wanting to please my dad, and I still feel like, you know, he's proud that I'm carrying on his tradition and his legacy.
I love to do it. It's just feels like it's like a family tradition. And Dad said he wanted to pass it down to me, and I've always liked to do it, so I figured why not.
Today you can have sisig. Sisig is a sizzling pig face.
Okay.
So tradition.
Sounds great.